Did that do? Sometimes the only way that you can be deep by 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 the way that you can go. Don't you know? Deepa, 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 oh my God, that deepa, 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 deepa.
Now we're going to speak to some creatures on the other side of the sea, namely the whales. Family-oriented mammalian creatures. write. They could have all kinds of wonderful, beautiful, epic poetry. Yeah, that describes their living in their family tree. I like to imagine that the whales have a song that they've been singing maybe for millions of years. On the king and queen of the humpback whale. Early on in their evolution, perhaps they spawned thousands and thousands and thousands of offspring. Maybe these whales lived for 1,000 years. And perhaps the whales have been singing this epic song about this new whale for over 1,000,000 years. Now think about it. We have epic poetry. Tales of Gilgamesh. For example, the poems of Ovid, the Torah, the Bible, and the Vedas. They're going back thousands of years that still move us and in some ways govern our lives. Imagine the power of an epic poetry or song that's been around for millions of years. But we'll never know if this is true unless we learn to listen to the whale song. Because the whales, they were able to sing their songs and do their thing virtually uninterrupted, except the occasional giant megalodon, ichthyosaurus, or other kind of large toothed predator. But mainly they have been unperturbed in their custodianship of the sea. I'm not even going to go into the mass commercial destruction of the whale population all over this year. Not 2 years ago, Japan, there's some shifty means to legalize commercial whaling again. For shame. Japan, for shame. But beyond the apparent and obvious horrors of mass whale slaughter, we have committed even greater atrocities to our majestic friends under the sea. Steve, I love the whale sounds. Yeah. You see, the machinery that we put in the sea, with its loud motors, all the pollution that we put in the ocean, the landmines, the weapons of war, all of these things create sound barriers that prevent the whale song from traveling its designated distance. So because of all the shit we put in the water and our loud motors, whale song that used to be able to travel for 10,000 miles will be lucky if it makes it 100 miles. Imagine if you have a sick mother.
Oh yeah, we cut off the whale song. They're not singing it anymore.
You have a sick mother in New York City. And you talk to her every day to make sure that she's okay, that the cancer hasn't taken her away. Some joy to her life, take away some of her strife. And then one day you pick up the phone, you make the call. No sign, no signal, nothing at all. So you go on the internet, no connection, no signal. You look at your phone, nothing, no Wi-Fi, no nothing, no hotspot. You just so happen to have an old landline. You know, one of those telephones? And you go. Nothing. No signal at all.
You're so old school.
You had a telegraph machine. Old school. Samuel Morse stuff. In your den. And even then, no hesitation. beat, no nothing. You're freaking out when you go outside, and you see other people are coming out of their houses, and they're freaking out too. No signal anywhere, nobody knows what to do. Well, that's exactly what we've done to the winter. Shawn destroyed their wonderful epic camp. Who knows what other creatures are dependent on the whale song, the particular vibrations of the deep? Perhaps they are great custodians responsible for a heap of creatures in their teeth. Perhaps we are actually destroying and damaging the very cause of oceanic evolution by the crap that we put into water, especially in the realm of sound pollution. And we don't have to do this. We have the technology and the science to create soundless, essentially soundless vessels. You don't need all these weapons of war and plasma and all this crap polluting the ocean floor. We have to take better responsibility for ourselves and our custodianship of other creatures on this planet. We have got to learn to listen to the whale song.
Sometimes it is so slow, like, it's really hard to know.
That's
but
cool.
Now it's definitely working, so yeah, we knew it was going. There's ebbs and flows. This is one of the drawings that I have, one of the posters that I have that I videoized.